to stay with the Egyptian society, orthopedic society, EOA, right or not? Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And I prepare for you just a new idea about reverse, because reverse is an idea from Europe, from France. Paul Grémond was the pioneer of inventor of this prosthesis, and is famous these words: we need a prosthesis that work only with the deltoid. I don't know in Egypt, but now we have a register of a prosthesis, and in Italy now we implant usually every year 80% of reverse, and just 20% of anatomical prosthesis. Just this idea and this prosthesis in Italy is number one, and in register of Emilia Romagna, the place that I live, is very, very frequent implant. So, of course, everybody knows the rationale of this prosthesis: height congruency, increased stability, medialize the center of rotation, and distalize the humerus. So the shoulder with deltoid without the function of the calf is possible to recover elevation, abduction, and external rotation. But which is now the new concept of biomechanics? Biomechanics is in normal shoulder, in normal anatomy, the COR is in the center of humeral head. But pay attention to new idea of the old idea of Paul Grémond. Of course, the center of rotation is in glenoid, in the plane of glenoid. But now it's possible to switch the center of rotation in the center of glenosphere. What does it mean? Is lateralize the reverse. So, new concept, not only in lateralization of glenoid, but the implant of glenoid, the glenosphere. Because in Europe, we learned about the wrong implantation of superior tilt. Because at the time of the Paul Grémond, the first complication of reverse was scapular notching. Everybody knows the problem about scapular notching, or the osteolysis of the pillar of glenoid, and because of course is the first moment, is the first problem to mobilize the glenosphere. So if you implant without superior tilt or in inferior tilting, is possible to avoid scapular notching. But very important is not in Europe, not every surgeon was agree about inferior tilting, because yes, it's important to avoid scapular notching, but pay attention to remove a lot of bone in inferior part of glenoid, because glenoid, sometimes you can have erosion of the bone, and if you remove the inferior part to promote and to implant the glenoid in inferior tilting, you can increase the risk of glenoid loosening. So, another important point, not only the tilting, but retroversion of glenoid. In this in literature, is very clear to avoid the implant with the retroversion more than 10 or 15 degrees of retroversion of a glenosphere, because it increases the glenoid loosening. So it's important to avoid excessive correction of glenoid version. Another interesting point is the feeling, the sensibility of the surgeon, because reaming during the technique of implantation of implant of the glenoid is very important to avoid over reaming. 1 millimeters, that means 27% of bone removal. 2 millimeters, double bone removal. Another interesting point, if you implant with 10 degrees of deviation, you remove 24% of the bone. If you remove a lot of bone, you increase the probability, the rate of glenoid loosening, glenosphere. So, another interesting point is the stability. Another complication of reverse in learning curve of young surgeon in Italy is instability of reverse. So, to avoid this complication, you increase the size of glenosphere and increase stability, reduce scapular notch, but pay attention to torsional force at bone glenoid interface. So there is a limit of increase the size of glenosphere and to lateralization. So another important factor of reverse now is the length and the tension of deltoid, because another complication in our follow-up was the acromial fracture of reverse, because if you increase lateralization and distalization, you increase the tension, the deltoid, and over 10 millimeters, you reduce the efficacy of lever arm and the strength of deltoid. So, lateralize, reduce scapular notch, but in incidence of glenoid mobilization loosening was higher in lateral center of rotation than medialis center of rotation. So you avoid a problem, but you increase another problem. So in every field of surgery, the feeling of and the experience of surgeon decide which is the best implant to for reverse implant. Another interesting point is the the angle the of you can see to increase the lateral offset from the side of humerus. So the diaphyseal cervical angle on the left side, you can see 155, the old concept of Gramont. Gramont medialized the stem. In the recent stem, you have less cervical humeral head angle, but you increase the lateralized of humerus. And another possibility to increase the efficacy of the deltoid is to use the liner of polyethylene onset and non-inset. So, increase the lateralized of humerus, increase the neck, the deltoid efficiency, the deltoid wrapping. In Italy and France is very important aesthetic problem. So sometimes you can have in lateralized implant the best deltoid tension and to avoid aesthetic problem. Don't not increase torsional forces, increase the moment arm of external rotation, improving the posterior deltoid. But if you distalize a lot the humerus, you can have neurological impairment. Lederman described in very precise article, paper, if you distalize over 40 millimeters, you can have plexopathy, the problem of the tension of the plexus. What about new technology? Of course, every year in the shoulder and in the elbow, you have news. It's very famous now in the paper, in the journal. What's news? In the reverse, what's news in the technology? In preoperative planning software, in navigation, and in custom-made prosthesis. In Italy, I am a director of the school specialization in Modena, and every young surgeon now use the preoperative planning software. Why? Because it's very important to know before the surgery the position of glenoid, the erosion, the inclination, the retroversion, the subluxation of the humerus. And it's very important with the manual measurement like Lima, Exatec, or Zimmer. In Italy, I am a professor in public, so I have a freedom. I use everything. I use every company, and I have a great advantage to compare every company. I'm not a rich man, but I have a possibility to have experience to compare every system. I'm not a consultant or only one company. You know, of course, what does it mean? I am a freedom to judge every company. I use a lot of Write with a blueprint because I automated Miss Worman. What does it mean? Mean I calculate retroversion, inclination, and subluxation of humerus. I found very useful for my surgery to use Valch classification in A, A1, A2, B1, B2, C. What does it mean? It's important to know erosion of glenoid, but it's important to know if the humerus is centric in the centered position or subluxation. So it's possible to know with the system everything about this, and you can simulate the implant in the right manner or the choice of the surgeon before the surgery. Another interesting point is the seating. Seating is the contact of the backside of reverse with the bone, because of course it's very important to obtain, to reach the seating in the right dimension. Like, look at the red and the blue color of seating. It is very important to reach the blue color. More seating, more blue color. In anterior, posterior, lateral, in inclination. And you can choose the best contact of the metaglena. In some cases, it's important to use wedge. I debate in Italian society which is the best choice, bone against wedge in metallic, because it depends not only for erosion, but it depends from the quality of bone of the host. Because sometimes it's possible, Pascal Boileau described bio-reverse, it's possible to implant the chip and the bone behind the metaglena to implant the bio-reverse. What does it mean to prepare the surgery with glenoid and with humerus? The humerus, with this type of prosthesis, you can choose the lateralized of humerus, the stem, and the position of the stem to decide the neck shaft angle. So it's important to decide osteotomy, the level of resection, you can see, the inclination, the size of the stem, and the lateralization of the plate of the stem. Another interesting point is to simulate the movement with this implant. On the right side, you can see adduction, abduction, internal, external rotation to evaluate the movement with this type of implant. Because sometimes you can have the contact with the acromion or with the coracoid. So to avoid this type of impingement is in the software preoperative planning, you can see not only the position or retroversion, inclination, static measurement, static number, but you can see the movement and dynamic situation. But which is the problem about the preoperative planning, which is the weakness of technology. Blueprint tend to overestimate of too great of inclination. GPS Exatec tend to underestimate. So you can image sometimes the right number, but the accuracy is not the same. But significant difference in retroversion has been found with Blueprint software. So is important the reality and the fantasy of software. But you can have, of course, advantage. Identify anatomical deformity with CT in 3D dimensional, predict the final implant type and positioning, and in some case, use patient-specific cutting guides. PSI is pro and in Italy against, because you can have a mask in plastic and you can have the time to prepare, and the accuracy is not the same on navigation. And another problem is you prepare in the preoperative planning, but you don't know during the surgery if exactly your number is the same during the surgery. So another system that I found interesting was navigation, CT-based navigation system, which allows real-time control of implant and screw position. The other company prepare the preoperative planning, like in this maneuver, in this manner, and we prepare the deltoid approach more large, because is important to implant the trachea. This is a humeral cut. This is the trachea, because the trachea is impossible to implant with mini open approach. In mini stem implant, I use a very minimal approach. In this case, I 10 millimeters more large to see perfectly the coracoid, to have the possibility to implant the trachea. This is a time for landmarks acquisition with a special tool to avoid less accuracy. So accuracy of acquisition of landmark with a trachea is very, very important. This is a glenoid pilot hole, like a sheriff. Is a very important to have the point of insertion of the pilot hole and calculate antiversion and glenoid inclination. This is a glenoid reaming. On the right, you can see a video for the pointer and reaming and the deepness of reaming. This is a cage wall, the same on the right. You can see in real time the accuracy of the cage wall and the deepness to avoid the to perforate the cortical of posterior or anterior glenoid. In the right version, in the right inclination. Another interesting point is the length of the screw of metaglena. When I use the navigation, sorry, when I use the inclination, the navigation is possible to use the screw more with more length. You can hear me?
Yes, Prof.
Yes, we can hear you, sir. Yes.
Okay. Which is the great limit of navigation of this system, of Exatec? The humerus. In this navigation, at the moment, it doesn't exist the navigation of humerus. So we know just a side of the moon, not only the full planet. So the light of humerus, the position, the subluxation, is impossible to navigate now with this system. And of course, I describe and I cite this article, this paper, because the retroversion of humerus change with the retroversion of the glenoid. So in my operating room, usually I implant a humerus with 20 degrees of retroversion, but is average, is not so precise. Probably in the future with navigation, you can calculate the real retroversion of this patient, specific patient. With a good follow-up, we published 20 cases with navigation, and we use a posterior augmented metallic in 13 cases. In the first time of learning curve, the mean surgical time was higher, but now for the tracker, for landmarks, is decreased. Of course, it's important for infection, this surgical time. In the first part of learning curve, we had two cases of coracoid fracture due to the bad implant of the tracker. Advantage, preoperative study, high accuracy, and high accuracy in screw position of length. Of course, it's important to have long screw to increase the stability of metaglena and to know the position to avoid the stress fracture of the screw. The disadvantage is a risk of coracoid fracture, widening of incision, and time consuming, about 10 minutes. The limit is no information of humeral component and no control of glenoid final implant rotation and direction. At the end, I want to, because in Italy we have Italian company for the custom-made prosthesis. And I think in the revision and in very difficult case, the use of custom-made can help the surgeon to solve difficult case. Custom-made for erosion, for revision of infection of prosthesis, and the big erosion of glenoid. This is an example. You can see the custom made with the help of eyelet in coracoid with another screw and with the help with the special invention, like the name in Italy is Rivetto, with the superior part of a glenoid to have a good distance with a mechanical help of acromion. And this is a X-ray in post-operative surgery. You can see the lateral eyes, because in very medialized glenoids, the first complication is instability, but with the special glenoid custom made, it's possible to increase the stability of metaglena. We implant with a good follow-up 2 years, 5 cases, advantage high accuracy between planning anatomical features, very useful in severe bone loss case. Disadvantage is high cost. I am very lucky because I work in public university. It's impossible to implant this prosthesis in private situation. Of course, if the patient is very rich, it's possible. And long production times, 2 months for two from the CT acquisition. So in conclusion, sorry, but for me, it's very, very important to share with you the new idea about reverse. Preoperative planning software now is a routine in Italy. I want to know if in Egypt is the same. PSI in Italy is not so good situation, just in not a great accuracy, but just in selective case I use. Navigation is very useful in difficult case, is a good opportunity for positioning screw in metaglena, and for university is for educational to know perfectly for the student and for the fellows to decide with the surgeon, not in operating room, but in your office, you can simulate the prosthesis and the implant. Custom made, yes, of course, in some cases are necessary, but, sorry, the use is of not for every people, is very, very expensive, and is very important to know not only the bone, but the quality of soft tissues. Remember, the deltoid, the remaining calf, is important to avoid instability or reverse, and to you know perfectly the tension of the deltoid. Remember, the first pioneer near spoke and wrote the surgery and the pathology of the shoulder is a soft tissue procedure, not only the bone procedure. Thank you very much for your attention, and This is my hospital and university in Modena, because now I work in University of Modena. It's very famous in the world for Ferrari racing and Lamborghini, if you know Lamborghini, for the car, not only for the shoulder.
Thank you so much.
Sorry for my English. I hope was clear.
Yeah, it was very clear, sir. Thank you so much for your interesting talk. Of course, we know Lamborghini and Ferrari. We hope to have one.
One day, yeah.
Dr. Ahmed will be the moderator of this session. Yeah.
Thanks so much, Prof, for this fantastic talk, really. It's to the point, really. I have just a couple of questions to start, if there is any questions from the audience. Before I ask these questions, let me welcome and introduce the second speaker, Prof. Imad Zaid. He's an assistant professor of orthopedics at Al-Azhar University, Egypt. He's also doing some part of arthroplasty. He had a fellowship with Frank Golka in Bad Neustadt. He's with us now, and he will be giving the second talk. So,
welcome, Dr. Ahmed. Welcome, Dr. Ahmed.
Welcome, Dr. Ahmed.
Welcome, Ahmed.
Yes, it's nice to see you here, and we'll have some questions for Prof first, and then we'll go to the second talk. Okay.
Okay.
So, Prof, my first question about the notching. And notching exactly is something, sometimes I say it's a bit mysterious. There is no high quality evidence if it's problematic or not. There are many papers, good quality, say that it's not affecting the clinical outcomes. Other good quality papers say it is affecting. Maybe the last one from Simovic in last year, which is the biggest one, he said that there is a negative impact on the clinical outcomes. From your experience, what do you think? Is it a problematic thing that you see that when the patient has notching, he will have some inferior clinical outcomes?
Good, good. Very precise question. I appreciate it. Thank you. Glenoid scapular notch was described very clear for by Nero. Nero described grade 1, grade 2, grade 3. I think grade 1 in my clinical office and not fear, and the patient goes very well without problem. But if the scapular notch is until the screw, grade 2 and grade 3, I worried, and every year I check my patient with the prosthesis. So grade 3, when the scapular notch is until the inferior screw, I worry. And probably some pain and mechanical block in inferior part in adduction. Pay attention during the movement in adduction in internal rotation. Another interesting point is biological scapular notch, bipolar, because for me it's not important not only mechanical scapular notch, but if you, of course, you know the debris of the polyethylene, if you recognize not only erosion in the scapular notch, but at the level of the humerus, the bipolar at the level of the calcar of humerus, for me is another risk problem, because in this case, probably the polyethylene and the debris is a high risk of synovitis and erosion of bipolar bone.
Yeah, that's absolutely precise, because the nudging, one thing is the mechanical thing, the other thing is a biological. It's something exactly like what we see in hip replacements. It's aseptic loosening. There is some osteolysis that cause this nudging. And as you said, it would be affecting the glenoid side and the humeral side. So that's absolutely right. So we may find evidence someday, who knows?
Yeah. And I completely agree with you. So another interesting point is in French literature is very famous, the paper after 7 years of reverse, you can have the bad results and decrease of constant score or the clinical score. But in my research, I found not only mechanical problem, but the decrease of the strength of the deltoid. Because of course, in my first experience, I implanted the reverse only in very old people. Now I implant in the needle edge or in other pathology, not only in CTR, calf tear arthropathy. So after 7 years or seven years of follow-up, I think that the problem is not only scapular notch, but the decrease of the tension of the deltoid and the soft tissues tension and strength.
Yeah, thanks so much. That's a good explanation. I got one question from one of our doctors in our department. He is asking about the proximal humerus fractures, doing reverse total shoulder arthroplasty for proximal humerus fractures, and what is the clear indication for this? Is there a rule for MRI to assess the integrity of the rotator cuff to see if you can do hemiarthroplasty, or if the rotator cuff is damaged or the muscles atrophied due to age or whatever, then you can go safely to the reverse. What do you think about this this situation, proximal humerus fractures?
Very interesting question. I want to know, in Egypt now, 80% of reverse, 20% of anatomical or any, is the same of Italy, or the rate is different?
I don't think so, because of the cost. The cost of the reverse is about 3 times the hemiarthroplasty. Some few people doing the reverses. So we don't have a registry, unfortunately, so I don't have clear numbers. I may ask my colleague.
Do you have a register in Egypt or not?
No, we don't have a registry till the moment. So we don't have clear numbers. We may have some registries within the hospitals, but we still don't have a national one. So in our department, I can count how many. For myself, I didn't do any shoulders, unfortunately, because I have shifted my career to the deformity correction and the Elizarov. But I'm not aware of how many others. I would ask our colleague, Prof. Imad, how do you think about the numbers of reverse shoulder in Egypt?
Okay, in Italy, the problem, lucky, is in Emilia-Romagna, the public system until now works. So in the public hospital, the choice of reverse depends only from scientific data and clinical results. So if the patient is young, good tuberosity, good calf, middle-aged patient, fracture of the humeral head at the level anatomical or in the plurifragmental fracture AMI. But if the patient is old, plurifragmentary tuberosity, osteoporotic bone in the clinical history, a history of shoulder pain for the calf reverse, because the problem of the AMI in the past was the healing of tuberosity. So the trick is recognize if the great tuberosity is one piece, quality of great tuberosity and cortical bone is good, quality of calf is good, because if you have not good quality, the best option in the old people is reverse, because reverse for the traction, for medialization, the tuberosity normally heals. And if the tuberosity heal, I think the quality of the function is good. I treat a lot of AMI, in AMI to reverse, because in some case the tuberosity didn't heal, or another typical mistake is overestimate the size of the humeral head. So after 2-3 years, the patient normally has a pain in the calf and the glenoiditis. It's very difficult for the patient, for the function, for the pain to have a similar implant. And a lot of my patient wants now reverse.
Yeah, thanks, Prof. Yeah. It's another question. I think you came across the answer during the talk, but I would ask this question again for to consolidate the information. Regarding the glenoid erosion, how would you judge and choose between just over-reaming or using a bone graft or going for the expensive thing of custom prosthesis?
Good question. In the past, I attended San Antonio and Madsen and Rockwood, pioneer of this implant. Sometimes, if you read the theory of rim and run, in the past I try, but remember now, I don't think is a good idea, because you medialize the implant, yeah. And if you remove bone, you increase instability, micro instability of metaglena, and you increase the medialization with the high rate of instability of reverse. So my personal experience, but I have not numbers, I don't publish my experience to compare bone and metallic. But in young for me, sorry, is 55 because, or 60, my age. For me, the young surgeon is like my age, but the patient not so young. But in this similar age, I prefer bone. Yeah. In old people with erosion of posterior erosion or more inclination, I prefer metallic wedge. So I think the idea of bioreverse is good. For because of course is important for bone integration, bone quality of the humeral head and on glenoid. When I remove the humeral head of 80 years old, the quality of bone of humeral head is very bad. So I don't think it's a good idea by reverse.
Yeah. Okay, that's good.
Personal experience. I don't publish now the comparison of, I don't compare now with a scientific paper, bone and metallic until now.
Yeah. Yeah, Prof. Ahmad, go on.
You hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah.
Yeah, it's okay. Good. Just I.
That's fine. So maybe last one more thing, Prof, about the using the PSI or navigation. I have some experience in PSI with Prof Rostick, and from the numbers, from the literature, it would give you more precise inclination version, whatever. Yet there is no clinical comparison to find out if this is reflected on the clinical outcomes or not. But literature wise, it would give you some more precise position of the glenoid. My question, did you try it and find it's not quite helpful, or you just prefer the navigation as a live thing that happening while you are doing the surgery? Because the PSI, as you said, it's just a piece of jig that might fit, might not fit in the proper way, so then you will, it will not be useful. So what do you think about this?
Your question is the future. In my mind, PSI is an old technique. Why? Because PSI weight in custom made difficult case, but is not so precise. Why? Because you can have osteophyte, the position of the elevator can switch, or you can mobile the mask. So PSI is useful, but the future is navigation, because you can check not only the position, but the screw, the position in real time.
Yeah.
And in the future, the robotic is another, probably for young surgeon, because now in my university, the hip and the knee, the professor of Professor Cattani use the Striker robot to insert very, very, with a very accuracy manner, with the help of robotic, the position, the deepness, the relationship with two part of the articular space, the length of the humerus and the femur. And so I hope in the future, with the help of robotic, to calculate the right distance of lateralization or distalization of humerus and the retroversion, bipolar retroversion, to avoid instability and overtension of the deltoid. Because now the first enemy of reverse is acromial fracture. I have 2-3 cases of my patient in the post-operative was very happy. After 2-3 months, pain in the spine and the acromion. So I stopped physiotherapy for 2 months for the pain, and the patient was worried about the result of reverse.
Yeah. Thanks so much, Prof. No more questions at the moment. I really appreciate your participation in our course, and it's really a fantastic talk with some insights on the future also. Really, thank you so much.
I hope for young shoulder and elbow surgeon was useful, because it's my experience. And so I wanted to share with your society the opportunity of my experience with your experience. Good luck, and I wait in Italy and in the future in Red Sea, okay?
Sure,
absolutely. Thank you so much, sir. Hoping to see you in Egypt very soon, sir.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your invitation. I appreciate it a lot.
Have a nice night. To the rest of the day. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Dr. Ahmed?